Now, the expansion of USA. So far we discussed that how the natives were treated by the Europeans, how Europeans arrived in America, how natives arrived in North America and South America from Asia through the Bering Strait. Now we will discuss the expansion of USA. Earlier USA used to be a very small country, and how it expanded in the North America, that we will discuss here. Now we will read about the territorial expansion of USA. Initially America used to be a small country, but how it became quite large. So what treaties, what annexations were done by the America, that we will discuss today. Expansion of USA. You can see from the map that earlier in 1776, this was the USA. Only it was a small colonial country and it was colonized by the European people. So this was the USA. Because you know that the US or the American War of Independence, that was fought around 1775 and it came to an end this year only. Thereafter it was recognized by the Britain, the British Parliament, as an independent country, and it was recognized in 1783. So right after the American War of Independence, US was confined only to the eastern coast of American continent. Later on it expanded towards the western side. So what were the expansion and how it could be expanded, that we will discuss now. So you can see that in 1783, this area up to this region, it was merged with the US, and US became quite large after merging it. Then Old Southwest was also merged the same year in 1783, and this was the expansion of US. So in your book it has been shown that in 1783, this was the total expansion of the US. Later on, the other parts of US which are towards the western side, they were also joined with the US, and they were joined with the US under some treaties or after purchasing, or either they were annexed by the US military. So the Louisiana purchase took place in 1803, and this large area of Louisiana state was merged with the US, and US became quite expanded. So central part of North America also became a part of US. Thereafter Texas was annexed by the US in 1845. The years have also been written on the map. So in 1845, Texas annexation was also done by the US. Thereafter in 1848, Mexican region was also conquered by the US, and it was also merged with the US. Then Oregon County was also merged in US in 1846. So these were the areas which were merged with the US, and US became a quite large area. So at some places it waged a war, wherever other areas were joined with the US after purchasing it. Like the US fought a war with the Spaniards, and the southern part of US was conquered by the US army, and it used to be a part of Mexico. So these areas were merged with the US after conquering these areas by the US army. So this is all about the expansion of the US. Now as we have seen that US became quite large country, and many areas in the northern region as well as in the southern region were also part of the US. And you can imagine that the areas which used to be in the south of US, they used to be close to the equator. As a result, the climatic condition in these areas was of tropical kind. But in the northern side, it was quite temperate kind of climate, and there used to be a cold region. So we can see that a variety of climates are available in US, hot as well as the cold. So how the climate affected the economy of US, how it affected the policy of the government, and the lives of the people in US that we will discuss. So here you can see that it is written as the slavery. So this is the image of the slaves, and all of you must be aware about the slavery which was there in the US, and it was started by the European people after their arrival. So the climatic condition of the southern region was too hot for the Europeans to work. I told you that in the northern side there used to be climate, cold kind of climate, and since Europeans were the people who came from the cold kind of climate, because entire Europe lies in the temperate region, so it is having a quite cold climate, but the US has regions which are cold as well as hot. So the southern part of US, which were very close to the equator, they experienced tropical kind of climate. So in that tropical kind of climate, it was a problem for the Europeans to work in such a hot climate, because they were from the cold climate. So they were not having the habit to work in the hot climate. So it became a problem for the ordinary European people who migrated to US, that they were not able to work in the hot climate of US. As a result, they wanted people who could work in place of them in such a hot weather or in such a hot climate. So, the South American colonies had shown that the natives who had been enslaved, so the native people who used to be there prior to the arrival of the Europeans, they were enslaved by the Europeans and they were forced to work for the European. And so slavery started after the natives were made slaves by the European people, because they wanted them to work in the hot climate for them in their farms. So plantation owners therefore bought slaves in Africa. Now the number of the natives started reducing considerably, because many of them caught the disease, and as a result a large number of native people died. So now they turned their focus to another country or another region in the world from where they can get these slaves. As a result, they started transporting slaves from the Africa, because Africa was also colony of many European countries. As a result, the slaves from Africa were captured and they were transported all the way to the American continent, and they were asked to do the plantation work in the farm of Americans. So we can see till date that there are a large number of people, there is a large section of population in America who are Afro-Americans, who are from Africa, because their ancestors were transported during this time about which we are talking now, and they were transported as the plantation worker and they were enslaved in North America. So plantation owners therefore bought slaves in Africa. As a result, the protest by anti-slavery group led to a ban on slave trade. But the Africans who were in the US remained slaves, as did their children. So there were many people or many organizations, and they were having the humane kind of aspect in their mind. As a result, they wanted to abolish the slavery. So under their pressure, the slavery was banned from Africa. Now no more slaves could be transported from Africa to America, but the slaves of Africa who were already transported to America, they remained as the slaves throughout their life, and their children were also made the slaves. So no more new slaves were brought from Africa, but already existing slaves who were there in America, they were asked to do the slavery for the Europeans, and their children were also made the slaves. So slavery continued in America for a long period of time. Now again we will read about the slavery. You can see that this is the image of African slaves who were transported from Africa to America. The northern states of USA argued for ending slavery, since they condemned it as an inhuman practice. So the northern state of America, keep in mind, northern states of America were having a cold kind of climate, and their economy was not dependent on farming. As a result, they did not require much slaves. So they were against the slaveries. एंड बाय सेइंग दैट द स्लेवरी इज ए इनह्यूमन प्रैक्टिस सो इट मस्ट बी स्टॉप्ड. सो द नॉर्दर्न स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका वर अगेंस्ट द स्लेवरी एंड अंडर देयर प्रेशर देयर वॉज अ कंट्रोल ऑन स्लेवरी बट दिस कुड नॉट बी डन फुली. सो व्हाट हैपेंड नेक्स्ट. In 1861 to 65, there was a war between the states that wanted to retain slavery and those supporting abolition. So that I told you that the states, there were two categories of states, one who were in the favor of the slavery and one who were against the slavery. So there was a battle between these states and finally who were the winner? The state who were against the slavery, they won the battle. As a result, slavery was abolished. Though it was only in the 20th century that the African Americans were able to win the battle for civil liberties. So the battle for civil liberty was only won by the Afro-Americans in the 20th century, and they also got the constitutional rights in the 20th century. Able to win the battle of civil liberties and segregation between whites and non-whites. So when we talk about the apartheid, and when we talk about the racial discrimination, so racial discrimination generally is seen in America, and there was a lot of racial discrimination. There was a segregation of white and the black. So those schools, hotels, buses were meant for the white people. The black people could not enter in those hotels and buses. So there was a lot of discrimination with the black people, and it could be ended by a civil rights movement that started in America, and finally equal treatment was begun to be given to the black people also. The native people of North America lose their land. In North America, a large number of native people used to live there prior to the arrival of the Europeans. When Europeans started coming there, their numbers started decreasing rapidly, and they also started losing the land where they used to live earlier. So how they lost their land, that we will discuss here. In the US, the natives were forced to move by signing treaties and selling their land. So the natives were forced to enter into the treaty with the white Europeans, and under that treaty they were paid very less for the land upon which they used to live. So they were displaced from the area where they used to live by giving them a very low prices of the land, and they were forced to move from that area because the Europeans started thinking that the area which has been occupied by these black people or by these native people, that is quite fertile for the production of the corn and other kind of crops. So they were cheated by taking more land or paying less prices. So they were given less prices and land was taken more in size. The natives were deprived of their lands. For example, Cherokee. So example is given of a tribe, that is Cherokee tribe in Georgia. So you can see that this is the area of Georgia, and the tribe is Cherokee tribe. So Cherokee tribe used to live in Georgia. So what happened with the Cherokee tribe? This is a case study which we are talking about here. Tribe in Georgia was governed by the state laws but could not enjoy the rights of citizens. So they were under the laws of the state, but still the people of Cherokee tribe were not given the right of citizenship, because citizens are having certain fundamental rights. So they did not enjoy those fundamental rights. The judgment by the US Chief Justice, that is John Marshall, said that the Cherokee were a distinct community occupying its own territory in which laws of Georgia had no force. So under the judgment of the Supreme Court of America, and the Chief Justice of America, John Marshall, also gave a verdict that Cherokee is a distinct kind of tribe and the American civil laws should not have an effect upon it. Rather, it should be an autonomous kind of state. They can also exercise their own laws in their areas. So they were given some special right by the John Marshall so that the tribe could be protected. The US president, and his name was Andrew Jackson, refused to accept the Chief Justice judgment. So the Chief Justice gave a verdict in the favor of the people of Georgia, but the Chief Justice decision was not accepted by the US president, and his name was Andrew Jackson. He did not respect the justice which was given by the or judgment which was given by the Chief Justice. He ordered that the US Army to evict the Cherokee from their land, and they were driven out of the great American desert. So at the order of the US president, the army entered in the areas of Cherokee tribe. In spite of the judgment which was given in the favor of the Cherokee tribe by the Chief Justice, the army was sent in their area, and their area was evicted by the army. They were forced to move from their area because the area in which they used to live, that was quite fertile. So they were asked to move from there, and they were sent where? In the American desert, where the land was not suitable for agriculture. So they were sent into that area which was quite dry. So you can imagine that the life of these tribal people was going to be very miserable in that area. So 15,000 people were forced to move, and over a quarter died. So 15,000 people were asked to move, but out of those 15,000 people, approximately 3 to 4,000 people died on their way to the American desert. So they died on their way or in their journey itself, and they called it the Trail of Tears. They called this journey as the Trail of Tears. Those who occupied the lands of the tribes called the natives as lazy, not skilled, not learning English and dressing properly. So why these people were transferred from their native areas? So they were blamed that they are not civilized people, they are not making full use of the land, they are very lazy, they do not know how to speak English. So these were the allegations which were imposed by the government of US upon these people, and by these allegations the people who used to live in their native land, they were removed brutally by the government of US, and they were evicted from the area where their ancestors used to live, and they were asked that they deserve to die out, means wo jeene ke layak nahi hai, they should be killed because they are barbarian people. They were concentrated into the small area called reservations. So the small area was given to these native people where they could reside, and that was segregated from the other areas which were occupied by the white people. And these segregated areas were called as the reservations, means these areas were reserved for native peoples only. And there were a series of rebellions from 1865 to 1890. So the many peoples were forced to remain in the reservations, which used to be a quite small area. So these people rose against the US government's decision, and there was a continuous fight from 1865 to 1890. But since they were not having the modern weapons, so they were suppressed brutally by the US army. So finally they were suppressed, they were repressed by the US army. So once the natives were displaced from their land, they were sent to another area. But suppose in that area where they were transferred, like they were transferred to the American desert, if that desert was having certain kind of mineral, if there was found a mineral, then again they were asked to move from that area because mineral was required for the development of US. So they were continuously on the move from one area to another area, and while moving from one area to another areas, many of the native people lost their lives.